Greetings everybody, and welcome to another episode of Rebuilding the Commonwealth. We are back here at the castle with a few
it's
extra modifications.
This is Radio Freedom, voice of the Minutemen. All quiet, which is how we like it. Stay safe out there, people.
Great, you've mastered the art of talking without moving your mouth. First it was through a gas mask, and now it's without even moving your mouth. Lovely. Anyway, we are at the castle and I have put a couple of turrets up. I have a few developments to go through with you because it's been quite hectic the last couple of days. I've put a 40 round magazine on my RU556 here, so it looks pretty good. We have the officer defending the armory with some sandbags. I think it looks really good. I did put a security gate in here, but I think our finding can't quite handle it. This Minuteman here decided to steal one of the SA-80s. There's only two left, but not too angry about that. He's coming in to do his work. We have some food set up, and now the place is really coming along, but I have a few developments. One of the things is that the Commonwealth has got a whole lot more dangerous to go and venture in. Excuse me. What I mean by that is that we have patrols of the gunners, raiders, synths, not quite synths yet, super mutants, behemoths, all of the wasteland's finest can all be found wandering the wasteland. There's also a 50% chance that the ones I find will be large patrols, so I can be in for a serious amount of hurt. Now, my Minuteman armor is borderline overpowered, but even then, all it takes is two or three of these guys to have nuke grenades or a blowback, and I'm dead. It doesn't matter what, I'm dead. I'm hoping the fact that some of your place is under attack, I might be able to demonstrate what I mean by the wasteland is a whole lot more dangerous. So let's go over there and check. I'm actually dreading it. I think I'm just going to spawn in and get instantly murdered.
End of the line.
This is what I mean. Look how many motherfuckers there are. My friend, I got you. Get out of here.
I'm gonna be sick.
Okay.
You showed up just in the nick of time.
I was glad to help out.
Can't argue with your timing. Who knows what would have happened to us if you hadn't been here. Anyway, we appreciate the help.
Fucking glad. Jesus. So, the other development is that we are now level 61, given the attacks that we've had on our settlements. Not quite as big as I would have expected. our settlements are still kind of small at the moment. I've gone up with perception so that I can target more accurately in vats. And naturally I've gone up in agility to reload a lot faster. One reason why I put a 40 round magazine on it. We're also maximum commando, we're maximum rifleman. Pistols, not so important. I'm trying to think what other perks we could use to increase our VAT efficiency, because we really need to, I'm thinking about doing this one. Penetrator. I'm also thinking gun foo, but that's not really an increased accuracy, that's just as it is. Minus just increasing perception to go along with it, but that's just besides the point. Yeah, we have wasted all of these raiders. Nice. HK 4 fist 50, thank you. Right. So back to Sanctuary. Let me show you what I've had to do. I think you'll find it as disappointing as I did about what I've done with the place. And brace yourself, because it's going to be a bit rough. Now, the game crashed a few times while sorting this out, so please don't, like, worry about it or anything like that, but... Yeah, this took me a while to sort out. Once it loads up for me. Brilliant. Yeah. That is what is left of our apartment block. Unfortunately, the amount of graphic resources that it takes to build is just not viable for the size of the settlement I'm trying to build. If I'm going to build an apartment, it's going to have to be out of something else. But the good news is I have another idea for where it should go. We also have two settlers.
Yeah.
Good for him. He's reading public occurrences, as he should be. And I think I have one on farming at the moment to give them all jobs to do. There you go. He's earning his keep.
Hi, how are you?
Not really the clothes I'd wear for farming, but what can you do? Mr. Vault-Tec Rep is still just sipping coffee on his balcony like a lazy fuck, but what can we do? I've already decorated these apartments. I've put in all of the wallpaper. I've put in the walls in here. The floors. The problem with the floors is if I put in carpet, it really lags the game out. No, it's not my computer. I believe it's just a limitation of the game. Because my computer is really strong. I mean, I've got an RTX card in it, and I've got a very powerful processor. But it just lags the game out. And, I mean, there's some imperfections, but not too much. I'm planning to make into a garden, at least. And of course back onto the street. There's a few things I want to do with the front of this, but I don't know what to do with the roof, because I could make the roof as sloped as these ones, but I don't see the point. I really don't. The building is too big to make a sloped roof. But the good thing is this can sleep about 8 settlers. And we have a beacon, so we do have 8 settlers in. We've got plenty of stuff to attract some more, as is the case with the castle. So we're going to need to clean up and start making some more property soon, because we have some more people moving in. But for now, I have other things in mind, so bear with me just a moment, guys, and I will meet you there in just a second. Bear with. Lovely, and we're back. So it is a lovely, beautiful morning in Hangman's Alley. Now, as you will notice, it is completely barren. The frame rate over here is awful because this place seems to be a hot spot for war zones. No word of a lie, I had a pack of super mutants, raiders, and ghouls all tangling. It seems as though everybody wanted to attack Diamond City at once. Luckily, I noped the fuck out of that, to put it bluntly. But we're here to do some building. And as you can see, the All Settlements Expanded mod gives us a lot of space to play with. So I've already gone along and scrapped more or less everything, minus the bits that matter, as you can see. One of the interesting things I noticed as well is this settlement extends all the way to the bridge. Oh yeah, put a bit of patchwork in there. Oh, hello. A Raider Fiend. Yeah, I'll take that. Anyway, this building over in the corner, while I can't clean it out, I can actually build in it. Hence why I put a bed in it to see whether it's possible. And yes, yes it is. So I'm tempted to put turrets or a guard up here. That would be pretty cool. The outpost to get into Hangman's Alley. But for now, I'm going to get started on the bridge over here. I think this is a really good starting point to get going. Now I'm going to block the entire street off from this side. So I'm going to build some accommodation right over the top with a snap and build. So let's put some flooring in. I'm fairly certain I chose wood C. Yes, I did. Well, what do you know? Fits like a glove. Cool. We are kind of limited on space here. Because it's only going to be three deep. But I'm going to call this the Underbridge Hotel. I'm going to call it a hotel, but it's not really that much of a hotel. Now I need walls. Use a real estate set. What balconies do I have? They're actually really cool. I didn't even notice you had balconies. Damn. That's really cool. I'm going to have to do a mega project with one of these, I reckon. But we're not looking at that. We're looking for walls. Now, we don't want an interior wall because it's interior on two sides. What we're looking for is one that's exterior on one side and interior on the other. Like so. Nope. 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 That looks good. Yeah, I reckon style B is a good one to go for. So the back of the hotel, quote unquote, is going to be boarded up completely from the outside. Does that look stupid from the outside? No, it doesn't actually. Wait, what? I was gonna say, I thought I could build that far out. I was gonna be flabbergasted. Okay. Now this needs to be too high. Pretty sure that was... Yeah, it was fresh wood with the X pattern in it. Yes, you can have the dirty wall on the inside. You know, I really don't like this wavy outside wall. So we're going to brick it up with fresh one. There we go. Now that should look a lot better on the outside. Yep. Brilliant. Now this should not look awful. Get that corner piece out. I don't like the look of that. There we go. Okay, so you can kind of see the bricks here, but it's barely noticeable. Excuse me. Kidding me? That's better. And with the levels I've gained, I should be a lot nicer in terms of shooting in that. There we go.
No.
Absolutely. Cool. Let's just go up on top of the bridge and just make sure that doesn't look really daft. Yeah, I reckon a nice grand entrance to that, and we'll have a nice little accommodation area. This front place is going to be like a public space. You know what? That doesn't actually look too bad. Okay, the clipping's a bit off, but we can incorporate that into a defensive position on the bridge. So I'm not too worried about that at all. So, real estate walls. They don't do half walls, do they? Any half walls? No, just roof walls. I mean, I guess I could lower it manually, but I don't really see the point. I'll just stick with these. Ah, did wonder for a moment there. So I'm going to put in some door frames. Looks like I've only really got a choice of one, I suppose. Yeah, I kind of like the door at the top, the glass at the top even. Around the other way. There you go. Yeah, I think that looks good. Right, so I've got all kinds of styles there. Do they do just windows to fit in these frames, or do they just do great big fucking windows like that? That's a lot of windows. That's a lot of damage.
The fuck was that?
Are you serious? This is my territory, my friend. What are you doing on my turf? Beautiful. Okay, back to what we were doing. Half-size windows. Yeah, because they only fit like that. If I can walk through them, what exactly am I supposed to do with those? I must be missing something really easy here. Right, so they fit in the middle. Yeah, I'll be honest, I haven't actually used these at all.
This is bullshit.
Of course I do. Of fucking course I do, right. What are we doing? Yep, that's the wooden one. I reckon the caps look good there. Yep, I like that. Now we need to put a nice fat window. Get the correct wood styles. It's marble. I quite like the marble, but that's not what we're looking for at the moment. I think it's style C. There we go. Yeah, that's good. And I reckon just the standard wall will do fine for the edge.
Show them that.
Whoa, oh fuck, that's a patrol. I think we've got a war on our hands, boys. Fuck. I don't have artillery support here either. The small end of a patrol. That is just the small end. Jeez. Can't go anywhere with these guys around. That's two patrols that have walked past here as well. Since I got here, I didn't engage the first one. Well, who knows? This could be the same patrol come back. Now, there was a legendary. There we go. Take your legendary stuff. I killed the doggo. And I dropped a guy up here. And that's why I love this commando rifle, or the RU-556. Lovely. Okay. Where was I? Yeah, I'm looking to find my style of wall. I reckon the wavy outside can go on the edges here. That's fine. Yeah, that's the clean wood. That's a bit too plain. That's unfortunate. Yeah, I'm gonna have to go with plain walls, if that's the case. Can't be having that. I mean, I'll probably be adding some cosmetics to this anyway. God, it's like... It is a full-blown war zone down here. Hey, it's Codsworth. Yeah, I set Codsworth up to be the provisioner for this settlement. He goes from sanctuary to hit. Oh, fuck. Keep seeing this particular legendary a lot more now. Diabolos. Always has a legendary and always has an M27 Hellfire custom. Ouch. Can I not build for 5 minutes in peace down here? Okay, now as far as I understand, all of this is nav meshed, so this isn't an issue. Now I'm going to try and incorporate the curve of the bridge here into some kind of decoration, so... I'm sure I can find a way to plug that gap at the top. But this is the Underbridge Hotel. It's going to be pretty nice. Well, at least I think so, anyway. I can put in a cosmetic balcony up there, I reckon, just to make it look a little bit nicer. Let's do some windows. I'm thinking the three windows will look good. And I believe it's style B I'm looking for. Yes, it is. Go for a balcony. What does bronze look like? It looks really rusty, to be honest. Don't really like that very much. Yeah, what about wrought iron? Again, looks rusty. Fancy wood. Yeah, you know what? That looks good. I can put some lights on here. Yeah, I need to give it a bit more personality. The way it's just flat like that is not good. But that is for another time. Now, this is not going to be a massively fancy hotel, but it is going to be like a guest house, I'd say. Walls. Need to put down some interiors. Now the issue I have with these is they will no longer snap to one another. Because I've already put the flooring in. Then again, I won't actually need this. Ah, this is how I give the outside some more character. I've added some wall trims to give it a little bit of flavour. Now, I reckon a mezzanine would look good in here. So let's do the 32-inch, a 36-unit thick, and I want this nice marble-looking set. If I were to get marble stairs, I reckon an upper and under kind of style would look really good in here. Just a question of whether my settlers can get up there. Oh. Okay, your head can clip under these. It's gonna make my OCD go crazy. It's possible. Yeah, that's better. Quite like that. Perfect, so I'm going to take these down for just one moment. I'm going to expand out on the floor by an extra tile. Okay, what about half a tile? I reckon half a tile underneath as well. Back to stairs. Now I can put them back here. Yes, yes I can. There's a little bit of headspace, so I'm happy with that. Now let's put a couple of beds up here. This is a guest house after all. There's be a dog on the bridge above. Right in that corner. A little bit like the castle barracks. These walls are going to need some redecoration, but that can wait. Have we got any railings? Yes, we do. Something that can give the place a little bit of personality. There's any issues getting up there. Though, just to complete the look, we'll put it into the wall on both sides. Excellent. And if we've got any posts to make this a lot more well-rounded, that would be ideal too. Okay. Clip through? No, it doesn't. I like that. Brilliant. There can also be some further guest space down here underneath. I already like this. I really do. Hell, I would stay here if this was a real hotel. It can look over at all the other plebs staying in the hotel. Okay, so we're talking furniture. Those are far too big. Even that's too big. We can put a Minuteman flag up somewhere though. Now, this is a very grandiose hotel, so I'm going to put some rather nice paintings in it. That's quite a splash in it. I think I've already used some of these at the castle, so I want a little bit of variety. Whoa, right in my face. Have we got any smaller paintings? No, there we go. Portraits. I really want a portrait. Excellent. got, just to cover up this little gap in the corner, I think a nice, comfortable armchair would look amazing. Oh yeah, I forgot there was a radio chair. So we'd actually sit and use the bloody radio. Or an egg chair. I think an egg chair is pretty cool. Yeah, let's put an egg chair in there. Bookshelves? No, I don't think so. Don't think we need one of those. I think maybe an upper shelf would do really nicely though. So we can hang that above the bed. Now, if this is for travellers, I think some toiletries would be the best option. Just some sort of basic supplies, you know. Same with like Nuka Colas are pretty good for this, you know. Pack light. So this would also mean that the person travelling to this really nice hotel would bring a suitcase. Well, let's say they brought two, actually. Two suitcases. A table in between. I think a TV would be a little bit too generic. Do need to put some proper lights in here, though. Just some general decoration would be really good. Well, you always have an alarm clock. Coffee pot. Do we have a coffee pot? Oh, yeah, telephone. There's normally a telephone in these sorts of hotels. So we'll take one of those. Luxury living at 2287. Where are we these days? I mean, come on. I'm not sure what I'm looking for now. Don't have any of these pots, otherwise I'll put one of these on there because that would be a really nice addition. But we have no flowers. But we can always put a vase. Vase, I suppose, if you're American. Really need a key because you've got no door to speak of. Definitely a cap stash though. I mean, come on, any traveller's going to keep bottle caps with them, so I think maybe up here on the shelf. Oh, that's awfully placed. Yep, teetering over the edge a little bit. Nothing like being hit in the face with your own cap stash. Some pre-war money. And I think I actually have... It's not thematic and practical. Is it? G2M. No, it's not. It's not G2M. That's going to annoy me now. It's really going to annoy me. No, it is here. Okay. I think a hook with some clothing on it. Let's say, yeah, they're a travelling soldier, perhaps. That'll explain why they look fairly organised. They've got a little bit of stuff with them. I like that. Looks very nice. Maybe a tiny little end table here. And some, I'd say some, maybe some drinks, perhaps. Oh yes, of course, every hotel has a coffee or a teapot if you're in any hotel here in Britain, or pre-war toaster. Question is, did I bring any cups? Kitchenware. Don't think it'll be under kitchenware. I think it's under dinnerware? Yes, pre-war cups. But we have two beds, so two cups. And for the utensils, likely to have spoon. Do I actually have any spoons? Yes, I do. A couple of silver spoons. Isn't that good? Oh, I love that. I genuinely love what I've done up here. And how can it be passed off without floor covering? Do I do a simple rubber mat? No, I think I do one of the proper ones that come with it. Yeah, so that's under floor coverings. Oh, that's beautiful. Nice grandiose floor there. You know, Minuteman protection, they know who you are. If anyone comes up there and you haven't given them permission to be there, they'll be right on it. That's what we like. Now, let's leave the pipe up. I mean, it could be... could be we have a use for it. Now, given the fact I've already put this in, I think this could be a really nice reception desk, maybe a bar. Yeah, let's go with a bar. So, stores, food and drink, restaurant. Now, to avoid the stairs, we're going to put it here. This is going to be a way to totally drain my caps, I know it. Now, I think in Homemaker I have counters as well. Furniture, surfaces. Do I have the matching counters? Fairly certain I do. These are the matching counters. I don't think these ones snap. I do have a certain one that does though. It's just under the regular furniture. It's got to be. It's got to be under the regular furniture. No, it's not. Are you joking me? Joke. I've seen that. I've absolutely seen the counters which snap to this one. Shelves, not shelves. Or is it do it your shelf? Yes, it's do it your shelf, of course it is. Yeah, I don't mind that going over a little bit. Match up the colouring, but I can live with that. Let's get some power in here. Because it's starting to get quite dark. So let's put that down for now. And a long range conduit. Put it in the corner, just for now. Let's get some lights in here. I'm thinking spotlights. Can't quite get them to snap cleanly though. Down a tad, there we go. Yep, and we put some lights over this side of the room. And put that very close to the wall, like so. And can we get a very quick ceiling light as well? I think this one looks awful. Absolutely awful. I think this one sticks down a little bit too much, but oh no, actually that looks great. Yeah, I think that looks perfect. And a standing lamp, I think, for the little egg chair. Beautiful. I think that looks amazing. Now, under about up to your average neon. I also think I could put this in here. How funky do I want to look? I think that uses all the power that the generator can provide, so that's also a thing. I like it though. I really like it. I do think these lights aren't really reaching what I want them to reach. Snap these letters to each other? No? Okay, let's leave the that neon out for now. Yeah, I think that looks really good. So, at the back of the bar, I want to absolutely fill some shelves up. I don't think I'd use industrial shelves. If we're going with a contemporary look, I think these nice pre-war bookcases look a lot nicer. I think that pipe down the middle kind of gives it that bit of post-war texturing as well, so. Now we're going to fill this with drinks. Absolutely fill it. Sorry about that. Put some drinks in there. these drinks need to be on the top shelf or they'll click through. I don't think we have any boxes of drinks that we can put on here. Oh no, we do. We have some crates. I think the Vault-Tec rep would be amazing to serve here. If the population gets big enough, that is. Yes, I mean, this place is also a restaurant, so food is not out of the question. Yeah, fresh vegetables imported from another settlement. Stick with food and drink.
Move it on, people! I want this place searched top to bottom!
Is that another patrol? I think it's a small patrol.
Scanning.
Did he blow up?
Contact.
And that's bad. I think it was the Gutsy which did that. Ooh, nice. Thank you very much. Come again. I appreciate your custom. Excellent. So if a raider came in here, he'd think all of his Christmases have come at once. Jubbly. Don't really need to fill these up, to be honest, because they're not on display, but certainly doesn't help. We put some plates of meat underneath. To me, we don't really have a kitchen here, so food prep would be a little bit redundant, but that can still be done. Is it CWSS? Stores. Six. Yeah, that will do. Do very nicely. I think I can fit that in there. And then I can put, I think I can just put a standalone oven there as well. Without needing to put the full-blown kitchen in, because I have not got enough space for a kitchen, as you probably know. I know the modular kitchen mod was removed from not, but it did get removed from the Nexus, because that was an amazing mod. Yes, we have the pre-war version. Don't even mind that it's kind of on a show. You can't really get to me, my friend. The hotel is in the way. It's a shame for you, isn't it? Ripper. Can I simply block this corner with something just to make it out of reach of customers? Yes, I can. Just like that.
What's that sound? What is it?
Oh my god, it's a super mutant patrol.
Annoying.
Jeez, you can't get any peace around here. You really can't. It's incredible. I think we're going to have to go and deal with this patrol. Was a pretty easy one, wasn't that big. Mostly regular super mutants. That was easy enough. Mostly, anyway. Yeah, just regular ones. Probably could have done that even if I was like level 10. Would have to have been a little bit more careful, but certainly possible. Wasn't even a legendary in that lot. Cool. I can't even scrap the bodies. How great. Ooh, I know what's missing. Jukebox. Definitely missing a jukebox. Well, I'm thinking a TV behind the bar would be a good addition. You know, sometimes you have the news on at bars. Yeah, I reckon that would be a good little addition. And we do need a jukebox. Should have been a power, if I'm not mistaken. A porta diner. I'll think about it if we've got the space. Yes, there we go, jukebox. Okay, it does actually play music. It didn't have a power requirement, I was a little bit worried then. That looks beautiful, it really does. Question is, can I get it similar on the other side? I I don't know. If I get the walls in the right place, to be honest. Okay, the walls are not too bad. Oh no, I need an exterior wall for that. Interior half walls. Exterior half walls. There's only one way to see if that's correct. No, the bottom stair is slightly buried in the floor. Now it's correct. Yep, brilliant. Now we're going to put some floors in. I mean, I've already put some floors in, but... just these to pad out the gaps. Bigger. I just don't really want the outside world showing to a guest. That would look really bad. Wavy wall. No. That was a laser musket.
This is bullshit.
Don't tell me that's a gunner patrol coming out. This place is like a fucking war zone.
Movement detected.
Gotcha. down here. Hangman's Alley is a hot spot. Did I take out here? That was a lot of guys. That wasn't even full strength either. They're going soft on me up here. See, the Commonwealth is far more deadly. Hotel with a bunch of bullet holes and some blood stains. Fantastic. Okay. Rails. That's fine, it doesn't let any light out, so that's not an issue. Cool. Right, can we get some power items in here? Because this looks pretty awful. Leveled up, of course I did. To save my perks, I'm nevertheless coming across beautifully. Perception is 9, almost 10. I'm gonna keep going with quick hands. That's a good one. Now, does the wall appear through the bottom of the bridge? Because if it does, we've got a problem. Yes, it does. I thought that was another enemy for a minute. I was about to flip my shit. Can't even tell. So, furniture. Again, two beds in the old guest house. Mind you, I think we could only fit one in this guest house, this side, just because of the way the bridge is curved. Thank you. this person, or obviously bring their suitcase. Suitcases, sorry. They will have their own table. I think we have one Luxo Brew pot. Yes, we do. Though I think a tarnish might be better for there, because the Luxo Brew needs to go in the kitchen. Stuff on there later. One job at a time, I guess. Now some dinnerware, some mugs, two more mugs. Luckily for this, I have exactly two. And for being such a fancy place and selling Gwinnett, I reckon. A couple of Gwinnett bottles would be great for this. Maybe this reveller has bought a couple to go to his room with. That works. Just had to bring the conduit just a wee bit closed. Like that. It doesn't have any recognized anchor points on this concrete, so that's an issue. Feral ghoul head. That's a bit more bit for a hotel. Mountain rat roach. I think that can go in the go down here. Ensure we want someone to recognize our achievements. I think the same under here would be good. So, 1, 2, 3. we go. That looks good. I think I have to put something in this corner though. Okay, so now how about something for the very middle of the restaurant here? We have other kinds of hanging lights, if I'm not mistaken. Candles. I want to go with candles. Wow, that is an awfully weak light. No thanks. Do good. Maybe a pink one as well. Thinking the jukebox could be a central feature. Yes, because I think a really nice touch would be these booths. Booths. Set them up on the tier against the brakes. Get a pool table, but so I think that's going to take up too much space if I try to put a pool table in. Forward slightly to the left. exit facing the bar. When you get up to walk away, that's good. And what was the sort of seats for this table here? Let's put a toilet on it. Is this not a bar that we'd love to dine at? Because I certainly would. I'd love to dine at this place. Of neon on the outside, and it's going to look amazing. Stick a door in. Yeah, stick a prison door in. Just give it the complete wrong vibe. Go with the modern door. These doors are so foreboding. Just in case the NPCs have trouble, buy a little step to get inside. Does snap. give it a slightly more powerful generator, shall we? To build one of those, I'm going to need some serious power. Let's just attach this for now. Situation later. That is our bar. I'll probably jazz up the entrance off camera or something like that, but I really love how this has turned out. I really do. This is going to be like a nice little entertainment district for my settlers, so this is going to be a really nice little place when I'm done with it. But until then, I will see you in the next one. I'm just going to get beacon down, attract some settlers to this place at last. And we'll get going, so thank you very much for tuning in, and I'll see you again next time.